Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Rise with Raluca. Today, I want to talk about the intuition. We're going to talk about what the intuition is, how to tap into it, what is the intuition versus the mind, how the inner voice works in here, and what it looks like to start to integrate that in our life a little more. I am recording this post-eclipse season. So this is, it's Monday now, right before Halloween, and it was just kind of an uncomfortable eclipse season. The emotions were heightened. I'm sure a lot of people felt that. Some discomfort, emotions, anxiety, maybe sleeplessness. I had some like dental work done, and something is just feeling off, and you know, when you become so hyper aware of your body and a certain part of your body, you're like, is this right? Is this wrong? What's going on? So that kind of sent me in a weird thing over this eclipse. But I don't know. We're just going to wait and see and trust and go with the flow. I hope you're doing well after the eclipse season and that you had a nice Halloween. And let's just dive into talking about the intuition. All right. So our intuition is connecting to our soul consciousness. Our intuition is the deepest part of who we truly are. It's who we are beyond our thoughts, our fears, our emotions, our beliefs. It's who we are beyond what we are programmed to be. So I see our intuition as our soul consciousness. And a lot of people feel this in different ways. The intuition is always part of us and always communicating with us. So sometimes people will say like, oh, I'm not sure, like I've never felt with my intuition, I've never felt connected to my intuition, and they don't believe they can do it, and we always find a way. Like it's always there, it's always communicating with us. So our intuition is our soul consciousness, always communicating with us. It's our soul, it's who we are beyond our programming, beyond our ego. It's who we are even beyond this lifetime. So our intuition taps into that soul consciousness of who we are as a soul and is also connected to all that is. It works beyond the logic. It works beyond what makes us sense to the mind. And it just asks us to trust like one step at a time. Like one thing gets revealed at a time, usually with the intuition. It's basically like, you need to go here. You need to do that. Like, I don't know why, but this just feels really good. I don't know why, but this just feels wrong. And we're just meant to trust that, which is really hard to do when we have placed so much value and weight on the mind. We as a species use the mind way more than it was ever intended to be used. Our mind was just supposed to be like a calculator. Our mind was supposed to be the thing that helps us navigate this physical reality. But instead, we made it like the ruler. We gave the mind all the power and took it away from the intuition. So we took the power away from the wisdom and we gave it to the calculator, is what we did. And so I know we just put so much weight and value on it that we're like, if it doesn't make sense to the mind, if it's not logical, then we shouldn't do it. Like you need to explain a reason for making your choices, where we need to get back to the place that I'm making this choice because this is what I'm being guided to do. This is what feels right to me. This is what feels, you know, expansive, or I'm saying no because it no longer feels right to me, or I'm saying no because this makes me feel uncomfortable, and that should be enough. But we have bypassed our discomfort and those things that we feel over the logic. So we end up pushing our intuition farther down and farther down and ignoring it. And then we're wondering where it is. It's always there. We're just ignoring it. But the thing is, the intuition will always find a way to communicate with us. So let me break that down. Our intuition will communicate with us in any capacity that we allow it to. It will communicate. The channel can be wide open or it can be very, very closed. So when it starts to be open, we can feel the intuition, like just feelings in the body. Like if you're a generator, or I don't know, it depends on who you are as a person, you can have the inner knowing that you feel in the gut. So your intuition can be in the gut, where you feel like a yes in the gut or a no. Like a yes can feel expansive and light, exciting, and a no can feel like a dropping sensation. Or you could feel it in your heart. You could feel a lightness in your heart, or tensing up in your body when it's a no. Like, our intuition will communicate with us usually within the body. So when it's just open, it starts as a small feeling. When we connect with the inner voice, that is when we really, really like drop into that space. We really drop in our awareness in that space where the intuition is. So the intuition is everywhere. It's just what channel is most open. So for some people, the channel that feels most open to connect with the intuition can be the heart center. For some people, it'll be the solar plexus or the gut. For some people, they'll feel it in the third eye. Some people would just like, yeah, we just drop into it wherever it is. But it's whichever channel is most open. Like, sometimes it can move. We can feel the intuition in the gut, and then we start feeling it in the heart, at the inner voice. The inner voice is also the intuition. It's another name for it, because when we tap into it in this way, we hear, it's like a voice coming from within. So this is what we do in some of our sessions. We connect with the inner voice. We connect with that divine consciousness within you. So this is you. This is your soul consciousness connected to your higher self, connected to all that is, to source, and it can bring you guidance and insights of the highest good and in the highest truth. So when we're in this space, we really quiet down the mind. We breathe away the thoughts, we breathe away our fears, and we drop into that space, and really creates this space of awareness to connect with that intuition, to connect with the inner voice. And when we connect with it, it's like we start feeling an expansive feeling, and it starts feeling quiet, but quiet in, it's like a different quiet, like a calm quiet. And it's so different from the chatter that we're usually in the mind throughout the day. It's such a beautiful space. And when we connect with the space, people start feeling answers come up. And again, this is depending on how much we allow the intuition to come through. So we do some clearing. For some people, it starts off as just feeling yes or no answers, hearing yes or no answers, or very, very short answers. But within those short answers, there's a lot of wisdom. And then we clear away some fears, some beliefs of connecting with the intuition, because believe it or not, a lot of us are afraid of connecting with the intuition. We have a lot of fears that, I guess it's fears of trusting ourselves. Like, what if we trust ourselves and then everything goes wrong and falls apart? Like, what if we trust that voice and then we're led in a way that's not good for us? There's like this fear, like we'll let ourselves down and it'll destroy us. Or there's fears that if we follow our intuition, then we won't want to do anything, that will like be selfish and let everybody else in our life down, that all we want to do is eat chocolate and sit on the couch all day, and we won't want to do any of our responsibilities. There's a lot of fears around connecting with the intuition, but we just have to remember that the intuition is who we truly are. It is our higher self. It loves us way more than the mind does. I mean, the mind does its best, but the intuition truly has your highest and best intention for you. and those around you as well. And I think part of it is also the mind being afraid to connect with that intuition because it knows there will be some ego deaths along the way in this journey. So as we connect with the intuition and we start clearing some of those beliefs, some of those fears in the way of connecting with it even deeper, those answers start coming in more and more. And you can get such guidance, like people have received guidance in their what to do in their careers, what the next business steps are, like advice for their relationships, advice for healing, advice for what their body needs. Oh my gosh, it's just so amazing when we tap into that intuition and start asking about the body. We're like, hey, what kind of movement is the body craving more of and less of? What kind of food is it craving and more of or and less of? And that intuition can really tap in and communicate with the body. We can also check in on, you know, just if there's any like minerals that are feeling low. It's like all connected with your intuition. It's also been really cool to do this with homeopathy. Like I will have a homeopathic remedy for them, for the client, and then I will ask their inner voice, like, hey, how does this remedy feel in your system? Or like, or compare two remedies. And it's amazing when that they align and they don't know what the remedy is, but you can tap into the frequency of it in that quantum field. It's all frequency. We can tap into it like in an instant and receive the response from within. So as we clear those beliefs, the intuition starts to communicate with us more and more. So that's how it works with the inner voice. And the inner voice can give us answers basically on anything and everything we might be wondering about, but it'll also give you answers in your highest good. Sometimes you're not ready to know certain things. Sometimes certain things are not, they don't need to be seen. The other cool thing is that when we are in this space, it's safe for old emotions and beliefs and anything that's maybe not serving to come up to be felt and healed. And this is where we can do some like somatic healing, somatic work. You can feel that discomfort of the energy that's stored in your energy field, but you can feel it in your body with this awareness. You can feel it where it is in your energetic body within your physical body. And in this space, we also use energy healing and your own awareness to start to clear that out. And it's just beautiful because as you clear it out, that's something that you don't have to carry anymore, right? This is where we clear beliefs and this is where we bring in new ones. So it's just amazing the work we can do in the space of awareness. It's truly, truly beautiful. And the thing is, like, inner voice work is ultimately a crutch because what we're basically doing is we're going to this meditative state and channeling. But what we ultimately want to do is clear so much resistance out, to clear like so many doubts and fears and all that stuff we carry, that this intuition becomes integrated in our daily life, where we don't have to channel, we don't have to sit in a meditative state, but we're walking around and we feel that inner wisdom coming from within. We're walking around and we like naturally feel what feels good or what feels wrong, but we need to go through these steps of clearing so we can tap into that feeling and begin to trust. Because we want to be in a state of flow. And as we clear more and as we become more connected with our intuition overall, we start to trust that everything around us and in our life is happening in our highest and best good, because our intention has been to heal. Our intention has been to work with our soul, with our higher selves. So everything is happening in our highest and best good. And then we have to, as we open those channels up, we have to start trusting our inner nudges, right? Like we have to start trusting what our body craves. We have to start trusting the movement that we want. Like we want to be so integrated with this, to not have to like sit down and spend half an hour breathing and channeling at any time. We just want it to be part of our everyday lives. And it's been interesting because the more I've been doing this work and I've been seeing working with other people doing this work, it's like the inner voice starts to get quieter after a while. If we try to go into that space where we're channeling, it's kind of like, well, you already know all this stuff. Just go live it now. Just go do it. So it's like the inner voice at one point starts pushing you to just be more integrated in this life, to integrate that intuition to everything you're doing without having to like really kick the mind out of the way to connect. It's really cool to see it that way. So yeah, we want to get to that space where the intuition is just a part of us and we're living in this intuitive state. And it can feel messy because at one point you're like, why am I craving all this freaking chocolate? Am I really craving this chocolate? Is it coming from an intuitive place or like an unhealed place? And it's just another thing we have to learn to navigate. But I think we're all going into this beautiful, beautiful dimension, this way of living where we are integrated, where the mind and the intuition coexist, because we don't want to kick the mind out. We don't want the intuition, the inner voice to rule everything. And we don't want the mind to rule everything either. So we want to be in this place where we happily coexist, where the intuition makes the decisions for what's best for us, what's in our highest good, and the mind kind of keeps us safe and navigating this like physical reality. And it's great at making plans and doing like 10 steps and breaking things down, because the intuition doesn't really care about that. It's mostly of a general guidance of the direction that feels good, of what feels lightest. And I don't fully know what it'll feel like to be fully integrated. Like, I'm working more and more towards it, but I'm not sure what that flow and balance is between the mind and the intuition quite yet. And the intuition will communicate with us in other ways as well. In basically, it's just any way we allow it. And the more we allow it, the more ways it'll communicate with us. But if we're not allowing it and we're not like trusting our body sensations, it'll still communicate with us in other ways. This can be messages coming from other people. I've always also had my intuition communicate with me through like social media posts, like messages coming at the right time, things popping up online. I feel like the internet is very much working in the field of potentiality, and it can be very easily influenced by our energy. And I totally think our guides and our intuition will send us messages through what pops up on our feed, through what pops up on the internet. And it can communicate with us, yeah, through messages that come from other people. Other people in our life are beautiful messengers. Those messages that you receive at just the right time, or when somebody's thinking about you and sending you a message, it's all beautiful. Also, the messages might come through books, or if you see, like if you're shopping at a store and you see a book standing out to you and you pick up that book and it has the message that you need, or when you see a thing repeating like three times or whatever your number might be, it's all messages from your intuition. And it can communicate with you this way, whether you trust the feelings in your body or not. It just communicates with us in so many different ways, always communicating with us. And we have to start to tap into those heart feelings and our body feelings and our emotions to really connect with the intuitive side of us, and not so much in the mind. There's so much wisdom in our emotions. There's so much wisdom in the body. Like, we want the body to start leading and then the mind to follow, not the other way around. And the mind like has the best intentions for us too, you know, but mind is very self-preserving. So the mind is afraid of too much change. The mind would rather be in the discomfort of what is known, because that's more comfortable than going into something that's unknown. Meanwhile, the intuition knows that everything is connected. It like knows the frequency of everything. So the intuition trusts more, and it'll ask you to trust like blindly to the mind, which is scary, but it is not blind to the intuition. Yeah. So the intuition is trusting. It's connected to all that is. It sees things in the big picture, as in how it's connected in the highest good for you and all those around you, whereas the mind has a more narrow focus. The mind is self-preserving, and the mind doesn't have a lot of trust. So the mind is more like, how can we plan 10 steps ahead? How can we make sure that we are prepared for every possible possibility that we can think of, even though one can't possibly think of everything? The mind doesn't know everything. So the mind tries to like keep itself safe in that way, when it's such an illusion, and the mind wants to preserve itself because it's afraid of ego deaths, and the mind wants like, yeah, the next 10 steps planned, which is funny because they can change at any time. And like that safety is an illusion, and the routine is an illusion, and it's all an illusion because it can change at any moment. And when you are leaned into the intuition, the more you are okay with change and the safer you feel with it. And as a side note, a lot of this work is also connecting with and healing our nervous system, because when we are so much in the mind and so much in our anxious feelings, the nervous system feels very worn out and tired and kind of at its limits. And the more worn out our nervous system is, the less space we have for those things that are new and unexpected, because it's like your nervous system can't take another change or making another decision because it's at its brim. So we want to make sure we're loving on our nervous system, we're taking care of it. And inner voice work can help with this. Breath work can help with this. Somatic work can help with this. We just want to expand that nervous system to clear things out, to make space for safety. Okay, so we talked about what the intuition is, where we feel the intuition, what the intuition versus the mind. We talked about how our intuition communicates with us and what the inner voice is. And we also talked about how we clear things out. As we clear things out, the intuition becomes more integrated, which is so fun, like an exciting new territory. I mean, for myself, like this has just been more in the last year or so. I'm sure it's not new territory. I know there's plenty of people that are already fully integrated, living their life in flow, trusting their intuition, trusting they're carried, that they're loved, that they're protected, and following those nudges. So let's talk about how to begin connecting with your intuition. So you begin connecting with your intuition in a few different ways. So I like the body-based way a lot. That just takes a few breaths, just centering into your body and then beginning to ask your body, like, show me what a yes feels like, show me what a no feels like, and then seeing, just observing the nudges and sensations that you get, like when somebody asks you to do something and you feel an immediate yes, what does that feel like in your body? And when somebody asks you to do something and you feel a no, what does that feel like in your body? And then the more we listen to those nudges, when we like say the yes when we mean yes and say the no when we mean no, and I know that's hard sometimes, then they get stronger, because the more we trust them, it's like the intuition is like, yay, we're being listened to, let's keep going. And like that message gets stronger and stronger. So that is one way to connect. The other way to connect is through an inner voice meditation. We can do this in one of our sessions. I can help you connect with that inner voice, that intuition part of you, so you can see what that space really feels like. But basically, it's just breathing down into that space in your body where you feel your intuition. And if you don't know where it is, you can just focus on your heart. So what we do is breathe down into that space and we focus on the breath out. We're breathing away the mind. We're breathing away the thoughts of the day, breathing away worries. And we, as we breathe out, we drop even deeper into that space. So we breathe out and focus our awareness on that space. And then we ask questions. And when we ask questions, it feels like the answer rises up directly from that space. It's like words that come from within your body and they rise up and they want to come out directly without being filtered by the mind. It's very cool. So practice that. See what works. See how it works for you. I thought I had an inner voice meditation somewhere. I'm going to check. I'm going to see if I shared an inner voice meditation somewhere, and I'll leave it in the link below if I did. I'm sure there was one. We'll see. It might have been taken down. So that is one way to connect with your intuition again. And the other way is like practice with yourself with noticing the things that are around you that may be messages. Just noticing books that stand out, notice what pops up online, maybe even create rules for yourself. Like if I see this 3 times or if I see something 5 times or whatever, it's a message for me. Or you could be like, you know, like intuition, if I am meant to be to take this next step, send me a freaking butterfly. I want to see a butterfly today, or I want to see 3 butterflies, whatever it may be. It's like your game with the universe. You can do that as well. Other things that people do, and I have used as well, is using a pendulum to get your yes or no's, or muscle testing to get a yes or no. And muscle testing is just you're holding your ring finger and thumb together on your dominant hand, and then with your non-dominant hand you're pulling apart, you try to pull it apart, and you're kind of resisting it. So if it's a yes, it should be strong. If it's a no, it should be weak. So you can test that and see how that works for you. I do like the muscle testing sometimes still, but really we just want to get to that place where we're really trusting our intuition and where it feels integrated, and it feels integrated within our body, and we don't need any external anything to tap into it. So practice even tapping into that yes or no within your body, that physical feeling of what it feels like, and then ask questions as you're going through your day. Like, should I try this new cereal? Like, would this cereal be good for me? Would this cereal be good for my body? Should I take this way to work? Do I feel like doing this now? And just play with it and see what comes through for you. And the more you just set the intention to connect with it, the more different ways it'll express itself to you. Ooh, another way, cool way to connect with your intuition is through writing, just journaling. Just set the intention that you want to connect with your intuition and then ask a question and then let the answers flow through and start writing, let the answers flow through. And in the same way, at one point, it should start feeling like the answers are rising up from within your body rather than your mind. So within the body, it'll have like a feeling, it'll be like a more expansive feeling than the mind. And also the intuition is not fear. So sometimes we'll get like messages and we'll be like, you'll feel anxious and fearful. That's not the intuition. That's your fear. That's anxiety. That's the mind. Because even if the intuition tells you something that you might not want to hear, that might not be pleasant, it'll still come through with a calm and peaceful message. It'll come through with a calm and peaceful inner knowing. It'll be like, oh, well, that's not what I wanted, but like, I know I'm going to be okay. that's more the energy of the intuition. If it's like fearful and anxious, that's anxiety. We gotta go through that too sometimes, and that's okay. Just gotta feel it, and it's gonna be processed and released. Okay, so that is our little chat about what the intuition is, how we feel it, how we connect with it, how it's different from the mind and fears, and how it communicates with you. It's pretty cool. I hope you enjoyed this episode and learned something new, got something that you needed. If you did enjoy it, make sure you share with somebody you know that might enjoy it as well. And follow the podcast. All right. See you next time.